follow, this slope is covered with Helonius orientalis. So all these leaf rosettes belong to it. Well, Helonius was nicely flowered in the spring. But now only some inflorescent axes are left. Very interesting was my idea how to recognize it today. I wasn't sure what plant is it. It's not easy when you don't see flowers at all. But I found one plant which has a remarkable interesting feature. It forms small plants on the margins of leaves. Well, this thing is relatively rare in the plant world. So I tried to search and I was saved by the amazing, well, ability of Japanese painters, artists to show smallest details. So in Makino, illustrated flora of Japan, that plant is shown with a small plantlet. So that helped me to recognize this as Helonia. Well, and while I'm searching for Helonius and looked on other plants, I found something else. So these are small white stuff, small white flowers on a slope. What is it? It's a Burmannia. So Burmannia is even more amazing plant, if I can say that. Burmannias belong to monocots, and monocots which do not do any photosynthesis. So in terminology which I'm trying to use, they are plants 2 but not plants 1. So these are plants without chlorophyll, and even with a very much reduced chloroplast genome, which prevented to sequence them in a proper way. So the phylogenetic positioning of Burmanniaceae was delayed. But we know now that Burmannia are more or less close to Dioscorias and other plants of that group. So Burmannia are famous in a multiple different coloration. There are Burmannias which are purplish, for example. This species is just white. When you open the book and read about Burmannias, you frequently find the statement that Burmannias are saprophytes. Well, this is a wrong term. Actually, this is a kind of make things better than they actually look. Because saprophytic, saprophyte, initial meaning was just taking the nutrients out of soil. But there is no free lunch, no organic compounds in the soil. Everything is already taken. So the only possibility to take some organic compounds is to take it from somebody else. So these saprophytic plants are actually mycotrophic or mycoheterotrophic, which means they take this organic compound from fungus, which mycelia are always present in the soil. So fungi hope for positive interaction with plants. But Burmannia is cheating, and it will take not only water, but also organic compounds from fungus, and will not do anything in return. So Burmannia is mycotrophic monocot. Mycotrophic Burmannia and Helonius on a slope, and I'm staying in a valley nearby Tachiki. This is close to Ayabe, Japan. Generally, it's more close to the Japanese sea coast if you go from Kyoto to the north. Thank you.